Alright, y'all boys, what's up? It is GMME here, back here with another one. And today, man, y'all see, I know y'all very surprised right now. See, I got a little surprise for y'all, man. We got Sadiq Yusuf, man. Sadiq, how you doing today, man?
I can't complain, bro.
Yes, sir. And we're going to get right into it, man. Recently, Israel Adesanya, UFC middleweight champion, man, he was doing his own little breakdown. And he shouted you out, man. Just how cool is that just to hear, you know, have the champ, you know, shout you out on a big platform?
Yeah, Izzy's the man, man. He's always been one of those guys that's always shown me love since I got to the UFC. He was there at my debut, you know, so he showed a lot of love. I think I fought in Australia. So ever since then, to be honest, I think even before I got into the UFC, all of them have always been showing me love, him, Usman. So when I was starting the whole YouTube thing, he saw one of my videos and he was like, man, you got to put this on YouTube. And I was like, man, I put him on YouTube. It's just I don't have a big following. You know, the YouTube grind is like it's a little bit different. Yeah. I got all these other social media platforms. I try to get them to like come over to my YouTube, and it's so hard for them to literally just click over and hit subscribe. But he was like, yeah, he'll help me out, you know. So I really appreciated that. When he gave me that shout out, I got like 2,000 subscribers overnight. So that was really big for me.
Yeah, you have a very unique style of, you know, breaking down your fights on MMA Twitter. I don't know if you're in tune with MMA Twitter, but that's like you like the man on MMA Twitter right now, man, with your breakdowns. Oh, man.
I appreciate it, man. I try to do something different, you know. It's like I feel like a lot of the MMA things, like a lot of people are doing like similar kind of content, you know? So I try to do something unique. And it's one of those things where like when people see it, it's like, oh shit, all right. A lot of people know me like from my fighting and just the way I fight naturally. Like people don't know like my attitude, you know? They think I'm like some like angry, scary guy, you know? But I be on joke time most of the time, you know? So I feel like that was another way to get my personality out there. And like now when people read my damn tweets, it's like they realize I'm not being serious, you know.
Right.
Before, people used to read my tweets and like they just like read it in how they think I sound or how they think I'm talking, and then they'll take that job way crazy. But now they like they start seeing my videos and they realize like what type of tone I actually talk in. It's like I think now they're starting to be a lot more receptive to it.
Yeah, and I kind of want to ask you this question more so on a fight side, just like mentally preparing for a fight. Because, you know, I just recently watched Corey Sandhagen, you know, talk to Joe Rogan about it. You know, he's talking about he has to switch his mindset. He's going out there, you know, put someone in the hospital and this and that. And then there was another UFC fighter, I forgot his name, but he talks about like he doesn't like to celebrate because, you know, it's kind of like barbaric, you know, his opponent has a family and things like that. So I just kind of want to ask you just like your mentality, like going into a fight.
Yeah, I think what Corey said is like, I think that's probably true for most people. It's a combination of both of the people. I think was it Ode Osborne that said the second part that you were talking about?
Yeah, that's what it was.
Yeah, so to be honest, I feel like that's most of us, you know? A lot of us are, especially the guys that, like, lean towards, like, martial arts. Like, some guys are just, like, fighters, you know? They're like, hey, man, I got into this because I like beating people up, you know? But I feel like a lot of other guys look at it more as, like, either a sport or like a martial art, you know? So that's kind of what it is. You have to make that mental switch. You can't be a fighter your whole life, you know, if that makes sense. Like you can't, the same energy you're bringing towards the octagon, you can't carry that energy with you through life. You're just going to burn out. You're either going to do something crazy sooner or later, or you're just going to be one of those guys that have no real circle around you. Because the mentality of actually like going into that fight, most people know I'm a pretty cool guy probably 99% of my life, but the moment where we're about to like fight week, fight day and stuff like that, you got to hit that switch, you know. It's time to go to a different zone. But to be honest, where I'm going, I'm thinking, hey, this guy's trying to kill me, I'm trying to kill him, you know. It's like kill or be killed. So you gotta like kind of hypnotize yourself to where you're at that point, you know. I'm listening to my music, I'm talking to myself. It's you're almost in a trance. People think like it's a joke. Sometimes I go through my whole fight, I won't even remember. I won't remember the walkout. I won't remember Bruce Buffer saying my name, like you're so zoned into like what you're about to do, like you're just w ready to throw the first. But that's why I don't like even like shake hands or nothing when I fight, you know. Like as soon as it goes, like, hey, we're fighting, you know. And then like once the fight is over and you decompress, then you start watching like tape and stuff. You're like, oh, okay, this happened, this happened, this happened. But to be honest, that's how it is, man. When you're going in there, you got to hit that switch. There's some guys when they're fighting, I see them like laughing, doing the like, ha, yeah, high five, you know. But everybody's different. Everybody's different. Like to them, it might just be something fun, you know. So it is what it is. It changes as you go. And to be honest, it was one of those things a few fights ago that when I lost to Arnold, I started talking to like a sports therapist and like started focusing on trying to be more present sometimes in the fight, you know, so you can make decisions instead of just being on autopilot all the time, you know. So it's one of those things where I feel like there is a balance that you could have between doing both. But when it comes to actually preparing to go fight somebody, you got to hit that switch, man. You're about to go fight somebody in your underwear in front of a million people. If something's not clicking mentally, like that, like you're going to have a bad day, you know. Like you got to have that anxious, that nervous energy, and you got to put that towards somewhere else. And like where I like to put it is thinking, hey, one kill or be killed, you know. Like it's time to go put on a show.
Yeah, and speaking of the Arnold Allen fight, you know, he just recently fought Max Holloway. First off, what do you think of his performance versus Max?
I didn't think it was bad. You know, it's Max is Max, man. You know, it's like, that's I didn't really like once Max gets into his rhythm, it's gonna be hard to break him, man. Like yeah. It's one of those things you have to stop him from ever getting started. Or you have to, when he fought Poirier, you gotta be durable enough to stand there and bang it out with him. You know, I feel like when it starts turning into like a bang it out contest, Max is just gonna run up the numbers on you. Like you have to hit him hard enough to make him stop. And that was one of the things that Poirier did well and Volkanovski did well in their second fight, is that every time you connect, it has to be something crazy. His chin is durable enough to where you're not going to knock him out, but you better try every time.
Yeah, yeah. And, you know, Bryce Mitchell, you know, you got the featherweight division. I know you be looking. I know you be trying to scope it out. You got Mitchell in there. You got Topuria in there. I think he's supposed to be fighting Ortega. You got Ivanov out there. You got a lot of contenders in that top 13 range. Who are you eyeing right now for your next fight?
Man, to be honest, like before I got injured, I really wanted that Korean Zombie fight, man. But that kind of fell through. I think they were gonna give it to Giga. But funny enough, I feel like Zombie got hurt too, so it's kind of iffy. So maybe by the time I'm ready to come back, it might still happen. But I also felt like for a while the UFC was trying to rebook Giga, and it just wasn't coming together. So to be honest, as long as I'm fighting forward, I wouldn't care. The last three fights I've had, I won, and no, my last two I won, and I stayed in the same spot, you know. So I fought backwards against Bruce Leroy, and I stayed in the same number, and I fought super super backwards against the last guy. So I stayed the same number. So as long as it's somebody fighting forward, I don't care.
Yeah, okay, I like that. And you know you mentioned something, because I didn't even know about the Giga thing. Well, would you, like, if they came to you? I know you say you don't want to fight backwards, but
no, Giga's ahead of me. I wouldn't mind. Yeah, Giga's, I think Giga's eight. I think he's eight.
Damn,
don't quote Giga. Me on that. If he's not, he's either eight or like seven to nine. He's somewhere between that number.
I thought they took Giga out of the rankings.
Giga's still up there. To be honest, I think it's all right.
He's eight.
Look at that. I know my stuff. So I wouldn't mind rebooking that. Like, we was already scheduled to fight in October. To be honest, I still don't know why he pulled out of the fight, but it's one of those things. It is what it is.
Yeah.
And then they came back to schedule it again for April, and I couldn't make it. I was barely able to walk around April, so it was one of those things where I had to turn it down. It hurt though, because I think it was going to be a main event, so it sucked. But I couldn't take that fight.
Okay, but let me ask you this about the whole Francis situation, right? I've seen, I've seen a lot of mixed reactions in general. Some fighters are asking about, they're talking about they really don't agree with him. Then, you got people like, Usman and Izzy that we talk about coming out, in support of him. And I just want to get your take on the whole thing. What do you think Francis is making the right move? And he actually just announced that he's going to be making an
Yeah,
announcement next week, so.
that I don't know any fighter that would say they don't agree with him unless if they're like if they work for I don't get it. I don't get it. Why wouldn't you agree with him? It's one of those things where it's so strange, man. Like you shouldn't take the opinions of people, whether it's good or bad. Don't take it seriously because it's like people are fickle, and we always see this happen over and over again. It's like before everybody was all in support. Now it's like, oh man, they don't agree with him. Man, the guy's shooting a shot to make something of himself, So I don't see how anybody could disagree with that. If it works out for him, it'll be the best decision he ever made. And if it doesn't, he could easily go back to whatever opportunity that the UFC was going to give him. But I think it's a gamble that's worth taking, man. I don't think anything's wrong with what he's doing. I saw that then I think it was ONE FC that came out and said, oh, we're not doing blah blah, but that's just lame. That's these same people that are talking about trying to be competitive with the UFC or these media outlets that's talking about they want fighters to get paid more, blah blah, are the same people that would try to shit on somebody like Francis for making the right choices. Every time I hear about something that Francis asked for, it's always something good towards helping the fighters, So I don't see how somebody could shit on that,
Yeah, I don't want to ask you. Last question, because I don't want to take up too much of your time. July International Fight Week, interim champion Yair Alexander Volkanovski. I don't want to know too much because I know you're gonna do your own breakdown, so I don't want you to spoil too much. But what do you think about that fight? Like just the dynamics going into it. I just want to know your thoughts on that whole fight.
I'll give you a professional on here. I'll give you a professional on here. To be honest, I feel one Volkanovski is gonna be hard to beat when it comes to a technical matchup. Like we're just trading technique for technique. Good thing is, Yair is not gonna just be trading technique. Yair's gonna throw a million different things at you, and not one of them's gonna look the same. So I feel like that's one of those fights where, I would, if I a gun to my head, I will pick Volkanovski, but Yair could easily throw some random shit at Volkanovski and catch him. We've seen Volkanovski get wobbled quite a, to be honest, Volkanovski gets wobbled in almost every fight he's
Yeah,
had,
every fight,
but he's very composed. He gets his equilibrium back very fast. He's right back up to his feet very fast. But that's what I'm saying. Yair throws everything like violently. I understand like it's fighting, everybody's violent, but there's something special about the way Yair throws what he's throwing. Like it's like one of those, you ever grew up around a kid that like whenever you guys are playing around, it's just always hurting somebody. It's like that's what I imagine when I think about Yair. Is like yeah, we're trying to hurt each other, but like what, like he's like pointy bones, sharp legs. Like what he's throwing is just like violent, like it's painful. So if there's a good chance that he could catch on Volkanovski, but gun to my head, I'm definitely gonna go Volkanovski.
All right, y'all heard it here, man, from Sadiq Yusuf. He's going Volk. But Sadiq, before we head out of here, man, you got anything you want to tell the people, man?
Man, it's the same thing. YouTube, go subscribe to my YouTube, and I appreciate this, like you said, it's getting a whole lot of love to the, we finally got a damn sponsor out of it, so it's getting a lot of love. What I would like is more people to subscribe, and you could share the videos. Like that would be really, really important because the algorithm likes that stuff when people are sharing and commenting. So share and comment, subscribe. That's it.
Yes, sir. And I'm gonna leave the link to Sadiq Yusuf YouTube down below in the description. You should be following him on TikTok. Bro, your TikTok is crazy. I'm not gonna
Man,
lie to
dog, that's another one. No, man, I'm in like soup. Like when people go to jail, they put me in like solitary confinement in TikTok. I'm like in like super super shadow ban. Like it's not even funny. I've been shadow banned for like maybe a year. Before it was like okay, they'll start limiting my views to like a couple hundred thousands or something like that. Dog, in the last like 3 months, dog, it's like 2,000 views. I put up, there was one time I put up a video. That jump was at zero for about a week. So I'm liking like super, super shadow ban. So I don't know what's going on, man. I do know what's going on. I'm not gonna lie, I know what's going on. But I've apologized and I said I would never do it again. So if anybody from TikTok would please remove me from the shadow ban, man. I think I've learned my lesson. I learned my lesson and I'll follow the guidelines, you know. But yeah, my TikTok is man, like I said, most of the stuff, this internet stuff, I try to keep it all in a positive place where like use it for humor, use it for fun. I'm not the one that I don't like going back and forth with internet trolls about fighting and stuff like that. I'm not the one you're gonna be seeing like getting angry or something like that. I try to keep it all super positive. But yeah, get me out of TikTok shadow ban, please.
Yes, sir. Get up out of that shadow bad TikTok. But it's been your boy, Jim, man. Y'all know what time it is. Sadiq Yusuf, do something productive with your day, beating your meat. It's not productive. All right, y'all. See y'all boys next time, man. We out, man.
Peace.